Angular signal inputs offer a new way to pass data from a parent component to a child component. How do you pass the value into the property in the child component? First, we need to add the input function call to the property. The input function creates an entry point into the component for a value. In other words, an input channel is created for a value from outside. What happens if no value is passed? The input function may have a default value for the property, but this is optional. If no value is passed, this property is assigned the default value. What happens if the input function has no default value? This property is assigned undefined. Don't forget to import the input function. As an example, we use a plan present page with two components, a page and a plan. Second, we need the child component imported and inserted into the parent component. The child is imported into the class, but inserted into the template. Open the parent's template and insert the HTML element created from the child selector. This is the child component's HTML element. It's where we tell Angular to insert the content from the child template. We allow the child property to receive a value from outside. This is the target property. The parent property is the source property. Now, the child property is bound to the parent property. When the parent property is changed, the child property is automatically updated. This happens automatically every time because both properties are bound. Let's display the value of the child property in the browser. Open the child components template file. Insert the child property name with parentheses after it. We call this property as a function, but why? Because the input function creates a wrapper object for the value and assigns it to the child property. The child property stores the wrapper object, not just the value. The wrapper object contains the value. In Angular, this wrapper object is called a signal input. We can display this property as usual because it's a signal input object. If we try to do this, we get a warning. Call on this property as a function returns the value. The signal input has a special method to get the value. When the signal input is called as a function, this special method is called automatically and returns the value. Angular displays it. Let's return to the parent's template. All inside the double quotes is an expression, Bayesian expression. In this example, the expression contains only the parent property's name, but it could be more complex. This expression is executed and the result is passed to the signal input in the child property. For example, we can add a string to the property value. The result of execution is passed to the signal input in the child property. In this case, the concatenated string is displayed on the page. Expressions can be more complex. In addition to properties, expressions can contain strings, numbers, and other data types. We can call methods of the component. We can pass arguments of different data types. component properties can be passed as arguments. Expressions are executed in the context of the parent component. This means we have access to the properties and methods of the parent, not the child. We can also use the conditional operator. What happens if we don't provide a value for the input property? The default value will be used. What happens if the input property does not have a default value? The undefined value will be used. The undefined value is replaced by the empty string when displayed. How can we require a value to be passed to the input property? We must use required inputs. Angular provides two types of inputs, optional inputs and required inputs. Optional inputs don't require a value to be passed and can have a default value. In contrast, required inputs must have a value passed in and can have a default value. If no value is passed, optional inputs will have a default value or the undefined value. If no value is passed to required inputs, an error will be generated. When we use a required input, we must specify a value. We can require a specific data type for signal inputs. For example, the number type. This is the syntax for specifying a type requirement. In this example, the type of the passed value doesn't match the required type for the signal input. This will result in an error. Let's replace it with the string type. In this case, the type of the passed value matches the required type for the signal input, so we don't have an error. We can specify multiple types, separated by pipes. For example, the string and the number types. This means the passed value can be a string or a number. In this case, the Boolean type is not valid. Now I explain how required types work with the default value in optional inputs. The default value must match the required type if specified. What happens if required types are not used? The required type is set automatically from the default value type. In other words, the required type is the default value type. What happens if the required type and the default value are not specified? In this case, the signal input can have a value of any type. We can use an alias for the input name in the parent template. Let's use a different name in the parent template from the input property name in the child component. We need to add an option in the input function for this to work. The option subject is passed as an argument. The alias option allows you to specify a different name for the input property. Now it works. Inside the component class, we must use the property name, but not the alias. The option subject is passed as the first argument to required inputs. The second argument for optional inputs. Let's change the name back and look at one more option. The next option allows you to intercept and change the passed value. This option is located in the option subject and is called transform. The transform option contains a function to transform the passed value. This transform function receives the passed value as a parameter. The function must return a new value for the signal input. We can use a simpler syntax. The return type must match the type of the default value, but only if a default value is set. If the types don't match, an error will be generated. If a default value is not set, the return type can be any type. When we use the transform function and the default value, the type of the passed value doesn't matter, because what matters is the type returned by the function. The passed value is sent to transform function, not to the input property. The transform function intercepts the passed value, so its type doesn't matter. The type returned by the function must match the default value type. This is because the returned value is passed to the input property. If we don't use the transform function, the types of the passed value in the default value must match. We can use the transform function with a type requirement for the passed value. Let's specify a requirement for the type. In this case, the passed value must be of the specified type only. We can specify multiple types. In this case, the passed value must be one of the specified types. Every time the passed value changes, the transform function is executed automatically. The function receives the new passed value and returns the new value for the input property. This function is only executed for the passed value, not for the default value. If no value is passed, the function is not executed. We can use options together. The Alias and transform options also apply to required inputs. Let's create the plan pricing page. Each plan consists of a name, an icon, storage and a price. Let's start with the first plan and the name. The name is just a string. We can pass data directly from the parent template, not only from the parent component. The name property receives data directly from the template as a string. The price mode property receives its data from the parent component's property. Angular supports two ways to pass directly from a template, a string or an expression. The string is passed directly to the input property. It's not an expression, just a string, so we don't use square brackets around the input property name. When using an expression, the result of evaluating is passed to the input property. Enclose the string in quotes inside the expression. The result of evaluating the expression can be any data type. The string is always of string type. Please note, strings are not the same. In this example, we will use the string. Let's add two more input properties, price per hour and storage volume. The properties are numbers. Add new input properties to the parent template. We use expressions here because we need to pass numbers, not strings. Expressions allow us to get data from the parent component and perform operations. Let's add two more planes to the page. The component is a class. Angular creates a separate object from the class for each HTML element. Each object has data specifically from the HTML element it's linked to. The data of each object is independent from the rest. We can specify the values directly in the template. Each object uses the shared template to display its own data. This template is identical across objects, but each object has its own data to display. Objects use the child components template. Let's add an icon based on the plan name. In this case, it would be logical to set the price and storage as required inputs. We can also use required tag. Now, let's add a toggle button to switch between price modes. Add a click event handler for the toggle button. The handler changes the display mode to the opposite one. When the button is clicked, the handler updates the parent property. Angular automatically passes the new value to the child component object. Each object updates its own view. The price mode is updated, but the prices are not recalculated. In this case, we need to add a computed signal to the signal inputs. Let me remind you, input properties store signal inputs. First, create the computed signal using the computed function. Next, replace the signal input by the computed signal in the child template. The computed signal lets us execute a function when the signal input changes. This function recalculates the plan price based on the price mode. Every time the price mode changes, the function is executed automatically and recalculates the price. If you are new to computed signals and effects, I recommend checking out my video about angular signals on my channel. In just 20 minutes, I explain signals and effects in detail. If you are enjoying my videos, feel free to support my channel on Patreon or other services. You will find all the links in the description. Thank you! Signal inputs like computed signals are read-only. We can use signal inputs together with signal effects. The signal effect is created using the effect function. The effect must contain a function. For example, add the signal input to this function to print to the console. This function is executed every time the signal input changes. One change triggers the function for each plan, as each plan is a separate object. A single change results in multiple executions. Effects allow us to automatically react to changes in signal inputs. Computed signals allow us to automatically update values based on signal inputs. We can have multiple computed signals and effects for one or more input signals.